What if I told you that yesterday's pizza could be turned into energy? Well, in this video, I will explain what anaerobic digestion is, its benefits, and some of its challenges. Currently, much of the food, wastewater, and sewage, as well as agricultural residues, is seen as waste. But what if we could convert all of this organic waste into valuable resources? That's where anaerobic digestion comes in. Anaerobic digestion, or AD for short, is a process whereby organic matter is converted into biogas and digestate in the absence of oxygen. The organic matter used as a feedstock for AD includes crop residues, wastewater sludge and biosolids, animal manure, woody biomass, and food waste. Energy crops have also been used by many countries as a feedstock, but there are debates when it comes to land use impacts of energy crops. Which countries lead in anaerobic digestion and biogas production around the world? The biggest users of AD and biogas include US, China, India, and certain European countries such as Germany and Italy. There are different types of AD technologies which can differ based on the solidity of the contents, the feeding mode, the temperature, and the stages. For example, if there is only one type of feedstock, then it's called monodigestion, whilst if you mix different feedstocks, then it is called co-digestion. Anaerobic digesters also vary in size. They range from micro digesters to large digesters with advanced systems. So what are the benefits? The pros of anaerobic digestion are numerous. On one side, it produces biogas, which is a renewable source of energy. Biogas can be turned into electricity or used directly for heating and cooking. It can also be purified into biomethane, which can be compressed and used as a fuel or put directly into the gas grid. This is why it is seen as a potential substitute for natural gas, especially in certain industries. Microdigesters can be widely used in rural areas, with China being a good example. It can also be useful for people with little to no access to the electric grid due to remoteness or cost, as well as communities who use biomass for cooking. This also means it can reduce deforestation if solid biomass such as wood is replaced by biogas. Another benefit is that it also avoids methane emissions from landfills. Landfill waste is responsible for around 11% of global methane emissions, according to the World Bank, with landfill waste likely to increase in the coming decades. So, if the organic waste goes to anaerobic digesters instead of landfills, then this would further reduce emissions. Digestate is another product from AD. This is a nutrient-rich substance which can be used as a fertilizer. Thus, it can reduce the need for synthetic and mineral fertilizers, as well as reduce greenhouse gas emissions from the latter's production. It can also increase the soil health of land, and farmers can even receive tipping fees such as in Germany. Using manure in anaerobic digesters can stabilize it, increasing its value. Also, storing manure produces methane when it decomposes, so using it in the digester can reduce these emissions. Obviously though, challenges do exist. Biogas yields vary based on the feedstock used. Pre-treatment is important for biogas and digestate quality, as well as costs. Thus, to achieve the best results, you need well-sorted and available feedstocks. Feedstock availability may also be an issue, as some countries have poor food waste recovery and separation systems. High capital costs can also be a barrier for certain countries, as well as transport costs. Some papers also state that a lack of preferential loans and subsidies for this technology can be an important economic barrier to the adoption of anaerobic digesters. So, more political and economic support would positively affect the adoption rate of this technology. Finally, methane leakages can also be an issue, but can be sorted with stricter operating procedures, for example. This isn't exactly a new technology, as it has been used for a long time. However, its usage is starting to rapidly increase. With more investment and better collection and sorting, anaerobic digesters could help solve many problems the world faces and push us towards a more circular economy.
Thank you so much for watching. If you liked this video and want to learn more about climate change, don't forget to subscribe.